YouTube, it's your girl Hani. Today we are doing a video talking about Jupiter in the 12th house. Those of you who are wondering why am I jumping from 1, 2 to 12, I am random. I'm not very structured, okay? I like doing whatever I like. I do what I want, basically. So anyway, I thought I'd go to Jupiter because there's someone that I know that has this placement, and I have been watching his movement since I was 15 years old, and he is a very unusual character. I wanted to make this video immediately because I could not wait to the last video to make Jupiter in the 12th house. I couldn't do it. Jupiter is ruled by Sagittarius. Sagittarius is home to the 9th house. The 9th house represents foreign lands, distant travel, higher education, higher learning, cultures, traditions, philosophy, religion and traditions and cultures and different languages, whatever, you name it, okay? Jupiter is the planet of expansion. It's our blessings in life. I'm fixing my bra. It's just digging in. You know when you wear like the wire, you know when you wear a wired bra and it's just digging into your back? Oh my God. Jupiter is your blessings. It's your luck in life. You look to Jupiter to find what you are here to do in this world or what comes to you naturally. The 12th house, I always talk about this because the 12th house is a extremely misunderstood house. This house is home to Pisces. Pisces rules Neptune, and Neptune is one of those planets that I can't stand it because you can't see Neptune. You can't see what it is. It's basically very foggy vision. Your 12th house represents the subconscious. It represents dreams, illusions, confusions, hidden enemies, hidden talents, affairs, addictions, isolation, your imagination, institutions, jails, hospitals, foreign lands as well, actually. Rehabs even. This is a very... and I like to look at this house as the past life house and also the first 24 hours of your birth. This is a house that's here, but it's here. Like, you can't pinpoint exactly what it is. And Jupiter coming into this house, anywhere Jupiter is placed on your chart is going to amplify that particular house in that sign's expressions. And anyway, one of my friends, his Jupiter falls into the sun of Leo, into the 12th house. Now, Leo is ruled by the sun, and the sun is all about expressing. It's the soul's purpose, it's the happiness, and it's the ego. And the sun doesn't do particularly well in the 12th house. I've got a 12th house sun. So Leo being in there, it's almost like it's being suppressed to be able to express and expand to its true capacity. Jupiter being in this house, it's expanding, but it's expanding within. In other words, this is your house of imagination, the subconscious. Everything going on inside your brain is expanding, but it may not be expanding in the physical world. A lot of us recognize Pisces energy to be very selfless, very giving, very generous. And people who do have 12th house planet placements end up being someone who seems to attract people that have problems. And you are in this world to help other people heal. Jupiter is going to amplify these powers, and in some cases it can actually grant you with psychic abilities, because this is your mental state, your psyche. It can grant you with powers to be able to heal and help others. And someone coming to you with a problem, you as a Jupiter 12th house person, you cannot help but to want to help them. You want to heal them and help them through their problems, especially if it's in Virgo in this house, because Virgo is known as the helper. Pisces by nature is selfless. They want to help everyone. Then you've got Scorpio. Scorpio is the healer. It naturally wants to heal others. The house of secrets as well. And when you got Jupiter in this house, you can end up being someone, depending on what sign and how well or badly it's aspected, you could be someone who may take someone's secrets but not really express it. If it's in Scorpio, yeah, you ain't gonna be telling no one, because Scorpio in the 12th house is very private. You got Gemini in there, you're gonna want to tell everybody everything, especially if Jupiter is negatively aspected to Mercury. Okay, maybe even Jupiter. I don't even like, the air signs like to communicate, but I find Gemini in the 12th house is more likely to communicate a secret. And Aries in the 12th house, it's not very good at keeping things in. When Jupiter falls into the sign of Scorpio likes depth and researching and finding the truth, to research into the occult type of subjects, dive deep into spirituality, and Jupiter loves exploring. When it's in Scorpio does things in secret, and this is the house of secrets. So you're going to be doing a lot of exploring and coming into findings, doing a lot of imagination, using your imagination, and you may not share your findings with people. Okay, you may not want to tell anyone what's going on in your head, what you found. You may not be that person that wants to express to the world exactly what your findings are, because Scorpio doesn't want to share. One of my friends, he's got Jupiter in his 12th house, and he is a very interesting character. So he's got Pluto squaring his Jupiter. As Pluto falls into his third house, please people go and check out my Pluto in the third house video, it is deep. But the third house squaring Jupiter makes him someone who loves talking, you know, about occult subjects, spirituality, you know, history, things that are not widely spoken about into the world. Now, when Pluto comes in aspect to Jupiter in the 12th house, this is the house of your imagination and also escaping, okay? Pluto can make you escape into substance abusing. And this is not for everybody at all, because remember, this is the house that's connected to hospitals, to rehabs, to jails. You got this Pluto aspect, okay? It can make you want to escape into substance abusing, drinking, drugs, smoking, anything that relates to you escaping from realities. That's what you're going to do. Escaping for you may even be getting lost in a book. But because this is Pluto also represents addictions. Not always drugs, but escaping can also be seen as escaping into relationships, depending on what house, whatever. But Pluto is addictions too. When these people go into their escape modes, this is where they tend to be in solitude, when they're alone. And when they're alone, this is where they feel most inspired to get up. Jupiter in the 12th house, right? This is a typical placement for somebody who sleeps a lot, who likes to sleep, and they like to dream a lot. And in some cases, some people sleep so deeply they can't be woken up by you just poking at them. Like, they are stuck in this Jupiter 12th house mind frame. They cannot escape it. They enjoy it that much. These people need to be in solitude to be able to escape from, you know, the normal things happening in the world, like paying bills, okay? These people need to meditate, because I feel these people need it more so than anybody, because it helps to keep them grounded, and it also gives them that freedom to escape. You know, some people struggle with meditating, like an Aries Jupiter in this house. It's a hard thing to do. Saturn in this house, it's a hard thing to do, but you have to really work hard to sit back and literally be in silence, in a quiet room, in a quiet place, to be able to just float away, get rid of the sounds. You benefit tremendously from meditating. Meditating gives you that peace of mind that you need, because your mind is constantly running. It gives you the peace of mind, and it also allows you to feel inspired by new ideas. And what happens here is because your imagination is running so wild and rapid, the ideas that you guys come across, and this is not for everybody, but I've seen this happen, right? The ideas that comes to mind with you guys is so vast that when you try to express it to other people, other people that are also like-minded, because you're not someone who will share just to anybody, but to like-minded people, they may not understand how vast your imagination has gone. Like, why are you even thinking about traveling all the way to Indonesia when you know you can't fucking afford your next month's rent? You're not thinking clearly and you're not being grounded. And this is what Jupiter can do. It gives you the blessing of being able to escape from bills in the house, from your car payments. And the thing is, yes, you are supposed to pay these things. And I kind of feel like you need to have a lot of earth energy on your chart to be able to think in a healthy type of way with Jupiter being in your 12th house, because you can get lost in the skies with this placement and be thinking too much of, God, I need to travel. There's a lot of thought and thinking about traveling here. This is the house of travels as well as the ninth house. But the earth energy helps you say, okay, you know, I can daydream about traveling, but my earth energy will make it a reality. These people are constantly dreaming about being in a different country, you know, where there's mountains, there's hills, there's open land, there's happy people, there's no bills, there's not much money issues because everyone's living the same. These people right here, this is how they escape, by imagining living that way. And I always say, I feel like if you're imagining this, you should really work towards living that life, because that is where your Jupiter is most at peace and most happy, is you being out of the Western world even, or maybe even living in the countryside on your own, in solitude, or with your family who are all, you know, spiritual, and you guys are just, you know, kumbaya all day. You know, you have to be in an environment which is not so westernized. Does that make sense? Because you guys are always, you know, on a cloud nine somewhere, it is so beneficial that you guys do not work in office environments or in environments where you have targets to reach, you know, because Jupiter makes you not be focused or grounded on those targets, because it's not reality, it's not your reality. You need to have a job that allows you to loan work, to be working on your own, or even doing spiritual work. Because one of my friends, he's got a job and he's a courier, or he's a delivery guy. So he's on his own all day. And when I say the amount of ideas he comes up with, because he's constantly in solitude, you know, he's able to really stimulate and use his Jupiter to benefit him. But those people who are working in offices around other people who are just grounded, focusing on making the money, they are not going to feel stimulated in that environment. You have to work in a job that allows you to dive deep into your spirituality, allows you to travel and explore, or allows you to be on your own in solitude. Jupiter can also be seen as like how you're spending your money as well, okay? What's crazy is, because this is the house of spirituality, and people who have Jupiter in here will most likely have a large crystal collection, have lots of frankincense, lots of incense sticks, because they like to spend their money on their spiritual development and protection, okay? Jupiter in this house also can protect you as well, I forgot to mention, protect you from your hidden enemies, people that are after you for whatever reason. Jupiter's like, oh hell no, you know, you're going to be optimistic about this, nothing can affect you. These people like to make their homes really spiritual, like it's mad, like my friend is all this. My friend, yeah, his house has got, he's got candles all over his house. His house is white, he's got lovely white blinds, and the house has constantly got incense, frankincense burning. He's got a Buddha, you know, he's made it so it's very inviting and very comfortable for the energy to feel like it can just free up itself in his house. And this is typical for a Jupiter 12th house person. Now, Jupiter can be seen as the husband on a woman's chart. Okay, so when Jupiter falls into your 12th house, your husband may be somebody who is very spiritual. You may meet him on a spiritual retreat somewhere, in a meditation class, in a yoga class, a yoga session. But because this is also the house of solitude, you may meet him and he may be in a prison. He may be in a rehab. He may be somewhere which you cannot get to immediately because you have to be separate. He may even be in a different fucking country. This is a house of travels as well. So you've got to kind of bear in mind that there's going to be some type of solitude between the both of you before you can actually reap the benefits of being together. But most likely you would meet this man during your spiritual growth and development. So I think my main concern with Jupiter being here is that you have this running battle with spending money on your spiritual development or spending money on real life things like bills and car payments or debt. You can end up in financial problems with this placement because, again, Jupiter may be strong, maybe so strong, you may be constantly just imagining things and wanting to travel and spending money on, oh, I should go to Indonesia next month because there is a massive yoga festival there and it's going to be beneficial for me and feeling at peace with myself. But you know damn well you've got rent due next week or next month or whatever, and you're not always thinking clearly. Like, this guy called me, like this guy rang me a few days ago and said to me, oh honey, shall I get a new car? Bearing in mind I know his financial situation and he's still paying his car payments for his current car. So I almost got so angry because I don't get how you're thinking about buying a new car, okay, when you know that you've got payments on that car still and your financial situation is not comfortable right now. Is that really a wise choice? And I always forget, hello people, I always have to remind myself that people are not going to be thinking the same way I'm thinking, so I can't be mad at them. But this is what Jupiter does. It makes you forget. It takes you away from the realities of life and puts you on cloud nine. Okay, so Jupiter can be good, but you have to learn to work with it more so career wise okay, pick realistic jobs and know how to use your Jupiter to benefit yourself and to heal others than to just live in this Western world and pay bills and end up in debt and not really know how to use it. You can get stuck. So don't be stuck. Don't be that person. Just work with your Jupiter. Anyway, that is my Jupiter in the 12th house video. I hope you guys have thoroughly enjoyed it. I will see you on the next one, people. Take care.